Yokozuna versus Ross Greenberg.
This was a very enjoyable little squash match, and
I'll say
they Yokozuna just did a lariat or something early and just fucking killed this guy. And you actually heard this crowd audibly gasp that somebody had been killed in front of their eyes. Even back then, people just wanted some good violence.
Yeah. So Yoko destroys this poor man. Pins with the bonsai drop. And both before and after the match, he is doing these sumo poses. And the announcers are just clueless. Even though he's clearly a sumo wrestler doing a sumo gimmick wearing sumo gear, they have no idea what this pre and post-match ceremonial stuff is.
I was just laughing that we're watching this fucking match, and they go, let's go to clips from Superstars.
Yeah.
There was an incident this weekend with Yokozuna and Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Yeah, they aired this after the Yokozuna match.
Yes.
It's very strange to me.
So they go to Superstars, and Yokozuna's there in the ring, and Mr. Fuji's got the Japanese flag, and Hacksaw Jim Duggan's got the American flag. And they're fucking waving their flags at each other. Like, it's 1993. This war ended in 1945. And we've got an America versus Japan war on Raw in 1993.
It was all about...
And the fans are chanting, USA!
It was all about cars.
Too many Toyotas, but it's fucking ridiculous.
Nissans. Yes.
It wasn't a real war.
I'm aware.
The actual war was fucking 50 years earlier.
Yes.
And they're making Pearl Harbor references.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And I will say the one good thing about it is they've played up that Yokozuna has never been taken off of his feet. And they do this... basically, a sumo match.
They basically had a sumo match. There was a ref in there counting falls.
They stand across from each other. They run at each other, and they bonk into each other. And Hacksaw runs at him, and he gives him this big lariat. And Yokozuna, all he does is he stands there, but he goes, oh, and he shakes his hands. The fucking crowd.
Yes.
And this, I know they did crowd swinging at the time, but this is an example where you can see this fucking crowd. They're on their feet for this.
Yes.
This guy's waving his arms. They're going, oh! And then Hacksaw gives him another one, and he goes, oh! And the crowd's going totally crazy, gets his bounce back. And then finally, Hacksaw hits him with a third one. He doesn't fall down. He goes, oh! Oh! And finally, he takes one bump, and this fucking roof blew off this place because Yokozuna took a bump. I was like, my God.
Yes.
And just the way that he sold getting hit was so fucking cartoonish. Like, it's not like Ishii, where, you know, you hit him really hard and it's believable. This was a fucking cartoon. But because he'd never been taken off of his feet, they shot this angle on Superstars, and it had to go across the WWE television network. They had aired on Raw and Superstars and fucking Body Stars or whatever, the WBF. Every show had to have this clip of this American knocking down this Japanese man and finally taking him off his feet. That part was actually great.
This actually did look awesome, and I wish we could have seen the whole thing. It would have been better than anything on this episode of Raw, for sure.
Well, listen, Hacksaw's not a great worker.
What?
But he is a fucking incredible Hacksaw.
Yes.
He's a great promo. Like, even last week, that fucking stupid promo he cut on the phone, it was still one of the best promos I'd heard in forever. And he goes out there, and his gimmick is that he is an American. And for these American fans, he's going to take out this foreigner. And these fans just eat it up. And he knows exactly what to do. And Yokozuna knew exactly how to sell. It was actually a great professional wrestling moment that could be recreated in any era, but it's not anymore.
When Hacksaw hit him on the third time and Yoko started windmilling his arms and wobbling back and forth, when he finally hit, grown men jumped out of their seats and were pumping their fists in the air like their team had just won the Super Bowl. It was incredible.
So Hacksaw,
America had won, Craig. America was victorious.
I saw Midway. I know how it ends.
So Hacksaw celebrating the ropes. Yokozuna infuriated of being humiliated by being knocked over. Grabs the bucket of salt. And you mentioned the grown men leaping to their feet when Hacksaw won. But I was even more enthralled by the children trying to warn Hacksaw. Behind you! He has a bucket of salt! And they're screaming and pointing. But Hacksaw was oblivious. which is believable. Mm-hmm. And he turned around and Yoko threw the salt in his eyes. And
what happened?
What happened is
the announcer said he'd been Pearl Harbored.
Of course they did.
In 1993.
Of course they did.
God.
So he bonsai drops him and drapes the American flag over Hacksaw, and bonsai drops him again, and Hacksaw is stretchered out, and we get a quick promo from Mr. Fuji, who is not noted for being a good promo. I believe he won Worst Promo of the Year a few times in The Observer. This is a pretty great promo here. It's short and to the point, but he's just talking about how you dare to face Yokozuna. What happened? He squashed you! He definitely did.
Now, the funny thing, well, it's not funny, but it was a nice touch. Yoko had done the bonsai drop on Hacksaw draped in a flag. And when they stretchered out Hacksaw, the flag was crumpled in the ring all by itself.
Oh.
And they showed a shot of the crumpled up flag in the ring.
America's been wounded.
Oh my God.
Dude, and all they did was it was a hard cam shot, and they, as slowly as fucking humanly possible, like a glacier, they slowly zoomed in on this crumpled flag. Mm. And I was like, is done on vacation? They should have had 85 cuts to this fucking flag. We had one uninterrupted shot, which was a fucking awesome shot, by the way.
Yeah.
But we never see that anymore.
So this recap of an angle on Superstars was far and away the highlight of Raw.
CM Punk versus Garcia. Fast moving neck breaker, leg sub hold on. I got a pee. He gets light. This was 10-8-21. Clothesline. Pillman punches back and forth.
How'd Pillman get in this match?
I don't know.
What's happening?
If you enjoy these videos, for just $7.99 per month, you can enjoy full-length editions of The Bryan and Vinny Show, Wrestling Observer Live, Figure Four Daily with Tom Lawler and Lance Storm, The Mad Men Podcast, Speak Now Pro Wrestling with Denise Salcedo, and more, plus hundreds of archived shows, all in beautiful HD. Don't miss out. Join us today.